فؤادك الأيام فتى.
So الرحمن is صفة ذاتية and الرحيم is صفة فعلية. That's what we said, right? الرحمن is what? صفة ذاتية and الرحيم is صفة فعلية. And there are evidences that the ulama brought to prove that الرحيم is صفة فعلية and الرحمن is صفة ذاتية. سورة الأحزاب آية 43, Allah says وَكَانَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَحِيمًا. To the believers, Allah is what? Allah is very merciful. وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and also Allah's statement in Surah At-Tawbah, Ayah 117, Allah says, إِنَّهُ بِهِمْ رَؤُوفُ الرَّحِيمُ. To them, Allah is one who is merciful. And this is amazing because the word رَحْمَانٌ بِهِ أَمَّا بِهِمْ لَمْ يَجِئْ قَطٌ, never came in the Arabic language. It hasn't ever come as a verb, the word الرَّحْمَان, it hasn't come. So what do we realize? That الرحمن is a صفة قائمة, a characteristic that is present within him subhanahu wa ta'ala, and الرحيم is صفة فعلية, it's an action which Allah تبارك وتعالى does. Now brothers, what I want you to also inshallah ta'ala take with you here is a lot of scholars who explain this issue الحمد بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, they always bring this hadith which is the virtue of starting with the basmala. The hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Abu Hurairah said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كُلُّ أَمْرٍ ذِي بَالٍ لَا يُبْدَأْ فِيهِ بِبِسْمِ اللَّهِ فَوَ أَبْتَرْ. Another narration is, فَوَ أَجْذَمْ. Another narration is, فَوَ أَقْطَعْ. Any person who starts affairs of his and he doesn't start by saying Bismillah, then this matter is disconnected, meaning it's ripped, it's broken from the back. Are you with me? It's not something that's going to go on. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So that's what they say, or it's not something that's going to have barakah in it. Based on that hadith, a lot of scholars, they say to start with Bismillah, it should be done because of this hadith. And this hadith, let's speak about it, inshallah ta'ala. This hadith, Imam al-Khatib al-Baghdadi, he narrated this hadith in his jami'. Imam al-Subki, he narrated in his Tabaqat al-Shafi'iyya, from the following chain of narration. من طريق محمد بن عمران قال أخبرنا محمد بن صالح البصري قال أنبأنا عبيد بن عبد الواحد بن شريك قال أنبأنا يعقوب بن كعب الأنطاكي قال أنبأنا مبشر بن إسماعيل عن الأوزاعي عن الزهري عن أبي سلمة عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل أمر ذي بال لا يبدأ فيه بسم الله فهو أبتر. So this hadith is weak for the following reasons. The first reason why the hadith is weak is because in the chain of narration is محمد بن عمران. ضعفه الخطيب البغدادي في تاريخ. ضعفه الخطيب البغدادي في التاريخ. محمد بن عمران is weak. He's a weak. محمد بن عمران is weak. الإمام الخطيب البغدادي weakened him in his book التاريخ. Ibn Arraqin also said in his Tanzih al-Sharia. Ibn Arraqin, he said in his book Tanzih al-Sharia that this man Muhammad ibn Imran is Shi'iyun. He's a Shi'i. Ittahamahu ibn al-Jawzi bil-wad'i. And Imam ibn al-Jawzi rahimahullah suspected that he is a fabricator. He fabricates. He is a fabricator. The second reason why this hadith is weak is, in the chain of narration is Muhammad ibn Salih al-Basriyu. Muhammad ibn Salih al-Basriyu. Al-Imam al-Hafidh ibn Hajar al-Asqalani said about him in his book Al-Lisan. He said, فَمَا عَلِمْتُ حَالَهُ. I don't know his situation. Meaning he's unknown. He is unknown. This individual. So he's مجهول الحال. His situation is unknown. Also, Al-Imam Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar, he weakened this hadith in his as he transmitted it in his book, Al-Futuhat al-Rabbaniyya. Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah, in his Irwa' al-Ghalil, the first hadith, he started his book with is this. If you go to the book Irwa' al-Ghalil, the first page of the first volume, Sheikh Al-Albani started with this hadith. And he brought all of the chains of narrations for this hadith And Sheikh Al-Albani pointed out that this hadith is what? Da'ifun jiddan. That this hadith is excessively weak. La yathbutu. It is not transmitted from the messenger alayhi salatu wa salam. So that is very important that we remember that. Na'am. Then the Sheikh said, من أعجب العجاب وأكبر الآيات الدالة على قدرة الملك الغلاب ستة أصول. Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, he is really known, as Ibn Uthaymeen said, he said, Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, rahimahullah, lahu inayatun. He gives concentration. Lahu inayatun. Inaya is when you give consideration. You give efforts to something. Lahu inayatun. بالرسائل المختصرة. He gives a lot of effort, Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, in little books. Rasail are little essays, not big books, just little essays. Al-Mukhtasarati, that is abridged. التي يفهمها العامي, that the general mass can understand. That the general mass can understand. So Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab, his works is Rasail, little essays. Al-Mukhtasarati, that is summarized and abridged. التي يفهمها العامي, the general mass, they can understand it. وطالب العلم, and the student of knowledge, he also can understand it. If a student of knowledge wants to read the books of Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, it's easy for him to understand. He doesn't have to be a alim to understand it. ومن هذه الرسائل, and from those essays and from those little books that are written, هذه الرسالة is this one that we have with us, which is called ستة أصول عظيمة. Six fundamentals that are great. That are great. Shaykh al-Islam Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, and that's what it is. A lot of the usul al-thalatha, kashfu al-shubuhat, all of them are rasail, very small. If you look at them, the sizes are very, very small. And he was one who used to give a lot of consideration, and he used to give a lot of his time towards making it a risala. To make it a what? A risala. And the Shaykh then said after that, rahimahullah, إِنَّهُ مِنْ آيَاتِ الْقُدْرَةِ الْبَاهِرَةِ وَمِنْ عَلَامَاتِ الْحِكْمَةِ الظَّاهِرَةِ هَذِهِ الْأُصُولِ السِّتَّةِ. The Shaykh said that from the great signs are what? That are good and they are amazing is from the wisdoms of Allah. The signs that are the wisdoms that are clear is these six fundamentals. Why are these six fundamentals from those great signs? Because the reason is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he clarified for us our religion in a very simplistic, a very easy way. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he clarified for us our religion in the best of ways and forms. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he unveiled for us any ambiguity or vagueness that may lie in a matter. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he uplifted that and he brought it and he clarified it for us subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even then, there are those who are blind. They're blind. That clear cut evidences that clarify the religion, there are some people who are blind from it. As Allah said in the Quran, فَمَنْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقُّ كَمَنْ هُوَ أَعْمَى. Is he like, are they the same? Are they the same? The one who knows that this is from Allah and who understands it and he digests it. And the one who is blind from it, are they the same? Allah then says after that, إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. The ones who understand this are the intellectual individuals. The ones that are the intellectual ones. So the Quran and the Sunnah, they both clarified us everything which we need. And it left no one in the darkness. لِيَهْلِكَ مَنْ هَلَكَ عَنْ بَيِّنَةً وَيَحْيَى مَنْ حَيَّ عَنْ بَيِّنَةً. The one who's going to live is going to live good. With the clarity brought to him, and the one Allah wants destruction from, he is going to live with destruction in his face. This religion, what? As the Prophet said, تَرَكْتُكُمْ عَلَى الْمَحَجَّةِ الْبَيْضَاءِ لَيْلُهَا كَالنَّهَارِهَا لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكَ. I have left you upon clarity. The night is daytime. There's no nighttime at all. It's all daytime. لَا يَزِيغُ عَنْهَا إِلَّا هَالِكَ. The only one who diverts from it is when Allah wants destruction for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he clarified it. And he brought it to what? To our attention. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen then goes on to say, وَهِيَ. These six fundamental points are as follows. Al-Asl, there are six. Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen is going to give us all the six, what they are. Al-Aslul Awwalu. The first one is, that the Shaykh goes through, is Al-Ikhlasu, sincerity. The first fundamental principle is Al-Ikhlasu, sincerity. وَبَيَانُ الضِّدِّ وَهُوَ الشِّرْك. And to clarify the opposite of shirk. As the poet said, بالضد يعرف وبه تتميز الأشياء. And when you want to know something, to learn its opposite allows you to have a good understanding of that particular thing in the right way. And your perception will be better. الإخلاص sincerity وبيان. And to clarify, ضده وهو الشرك. Its opposite and it's shirk. The second one is, the second fundamental principle is al-ijtima'u fi dini wa nahyi 'ani tafarruqi fihi. To unite upon this religion and the prohibition of differing and dividing. The third one is, the third principle is as-sam'u, listening wa ta'a, and obeying li wulati al-amri, the leaders of the Muslims, to listen and to obey them. To listen to them and to what? To obey them. The fourth principle, al-aslu al-rabi', the fourth principle, or the fourth and fundamental, is bayanu al-ilmi, clarifying knowledge. What is knowledge? Wal-ulama'i, and the scholars. Wal-fiqhi wal-fuqaha'i, and also clarifying jurists. And jurisprudent matters. وَمَنْ تَشَبَّهَ بِهِمْ, and anyone who imitates the jurists and the scholars, وَلَيْسَ مِنْهُمْ, and he's not even from them. الْأَصْلُ الْخَامِسِ, the fifth principle is بَيَانُ مَنْ هُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ اللَّهِ, to clarify who are the allies of Allah. Who are the awliya of Allah? The fifth one is بَيَانُ, to clarify مَنْ هُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ اللَّهِ, to clarify who are the allies of Allah. الْأَصْلُ السَّادِسُ, the sixth fundamental principle is رَدُّ الشُّبْهَةِ الَّتِي وَضَعَهَا الشَّيْطَانُ فِي تَرْكِ الْقُرْآنِ وَالسُّنَّةِ, rebelling and refuting and rejecting the doubts that Shaytan has placed in leaving the Quran and the Sunnah. Raddu, to rebel and to refute. Ash-shubhati, the doubt. Allati wada'aha, in which he placed. Ash-shaytanu, shaytan placed. Fi tarki al-Qur'ani, in leaving the Quran. Was-sunnati, and leaving the Sunnah. Wahadihi, these six fundamental principles. Al-usul, these six fundamental principles are usulun, they are fundamental principles that are muhimmatun, that are important. Jadiratun bil-inayah, that consideration should be given. Jadirun, jadir is something that deserves. It deserves bil-inayah, effort and consideration it deserves. وَنَحْنُ أَنْ أَصْ, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, he's saying وَنَحْنُ أَصْ نَسْتَعِينُ بِاللَّهِ, we will seek aid and help in Allah Ta'ala, the High One, في شرحها, in the explanation that we're going to go through inshallah ta'ala. وَالتَّعْلِيقِ عَلَيْهَا, تَعْلِيق is a form of explanation. عَلَيْهَا بِمَا يَسَّرَ اللَّهِ, in that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala makes easy for us. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen is saying these six fundamental principles, they deserve for consideration to be given to them. And we, inshallah ta'ala, are going to seek help from Allah in explaining it, in pointing out and elaborating and commenting on this book, that which Allah makes easy for us, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Faddal.
Al-asl al-awwal, ikhlas al-deen lillahi ta'ala wahdahu la sharika lahu. وبيان ضده الذي هو الشرك بالله وكون أكثر القرآن في بيان هذا الأصل هذا الأصل من وجوه شتى بكلام يفهمه أبلد العام. ثم لما صار على الأكثر الأمة ما صار أظهر لهم الشيطان الإخلاص في صورة تنقص الصالحين
تنقص
الصالحين وتقصير في حقوقهم وأظهر لهم الشرك بالله في صورة محبة الصالحين وأتباعهم.
الأصل الأول, the first fundamental principle is going to be speaking about what? إخلاص, sincerity. الإخلاص is what we're going to be speaking about. الدين لله تعالى, sincerely doing the religion for Allah تبارك وتعالى. That's the first fundament. We're still going on. وبيان, and to also clarify. ضده, أما ضده, sorry. To clarify the opposite to it. وبيان, to clarify. ضده, it is opposite. الذي هو الشرك بالله, that which is shirk of Allah تبارك وتعالى. الذي هو الشرك بالله. So the first asal is about what? It's going to be talking about sincerity in the religion of Allah, and it's going to speak about the opposite to sincerity, which is الشرك. It's going to be talking about الشرك. Very good. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, we're going to take his sharah. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen's sharah is what we're going to take. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen says, أشرح قوله الإخلاص الدين لله تعالى وحده لا شريك له. Sincerely doing the religion for Allah تبارك وتعالى is alone for him. لا شريك له, and you do not associate partners with him. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen says, الإخلاص لله معناه. Sincerity for the sake of Allah means أن يقصد المرء بعبادته التقرب إلى الله تعالى. الإخلاص لله معناه, it means that the person intends أن يقصد المرء. مرء is a person. يقصد is to intend. The person intends بعبادته, with his ibadah he intends التقرب, to get closer to. إلى الله تعالى, to get closer to Allah. والتوصل إلى دار كرامته, and to reach to the Jannah. دار كرامته is Jannah. He wants to reach and he wants to gain Jannah. بأن يكون العبد, by the servant being مخلصا لله تعالى, by the person being sincere for Allah تبارك وتعالى, في قصده, in his intention, مخلصا لله في محبته, being sincere to Allah in his love, مخلصا لله, also being sincere for Allah, في تعظيمه, in honoring him, مخلصا لله, also being sincere to Allah, في ظاهره وباطنه, in your outer and your inner. What does he mean, outer and your inner? Your inner is your heart, and your outer is what? Your speech, your actions, and your intentions. So your speech and your actions. Your intention is the inner. That's what he means, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen. لا يبتغي, the person is not looking to gain, بعبادته, he is worshipping, إلا وجه الله تعالى, except the face of Allah. He is not intending with his worship except the face of Allah. والوصول, and to reach, إلى دار كرامته, and to reach Jannah. كما قال تعالى, as Allah said, قل, say to them, Muhammad, إن صلاتي, my prayer, ونسكي, and my slaughtering, ومحياي, and my living, ومماتي, and my dying, لله, it is only for Allah تبارك وتعالى, رب العالمين, the Lord of the heavens and the earth, لا شريك له, he has no partners, وبذلك, and in that, أمرت, I was ordered, وأنا أول المسلمين. I am the first of the believers. وقوله تعالى and the speech of Allah. That was Surah Al-An'am, Ayah 162 to Ayah 163. The second Ayah Ibn Uthaymeen brought was وقوله تعالى and the statement of Allah. وأنيبوا, أنيبوا means turn back to. إلى ربكم, towards your Lord. وأسلموا له, and submit yourself to him. Az-Zumur, Ayah 54. Surah Az-Zumur, Ayah 54. وقوله, and the statement of Allah also. وإلهكم, your Lord. إله واحد, he is one Lord. لا إله, there is none worthy of worship. إلا هو, except him. الرحمن, the most merciful. الرحيم, the most gracious. Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 163. وقوله, and the speech of Allah. فإلهكم, your Lord. إلهٌ, he's one إله, واحد alone. فله, to him, أسلموا, submit. الحج, Ayah 34. وقد أرسل الله, Allah, he sent. تعالى, the high he is. جميع الرسل, Allah sent all the messengers. بذلك, with that. With what? لا إله إلا الله. That's what he sent them all with. كما قال تعالى, as he Allah تبارك وتعالى said. So بذلك, take it back to what? When you take that إشارة towards, you take it back to لا إله إلا الله, which were mentioned in the آيات. كما قال تعالى, as Allah said, وما أرسلنا من قبلك, we have not sent down before you Muhammad. من قبلك, that كاف is you Muhammad. مِنْ رَسُولٍ, we did not send a messenger. إِلَّا, except. Look at this powerful verse. Because Allah said, وَمَا, Allah negated. And then Allah, after that, he brought إِلَّا. What does that benefit? It's like, لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا, we have not sent down. مِنْ قَبْلِكَ, before you, O Muhammad. مِنْ رَسُولٍ, from the messengers. Except, إِلَّا نُوحِي إِلَيْهِ. Except, we sent the revelation on them by saying to them, أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ, that there is none worthy of worship. إِلَّا أَنَا, except Allah. فَاعْبُدُونِي, worship me. فَاعْبُدُونِي, worship me. وَكَمَا وَضَّحَ اللَّهُ, and the way Allah clarified. وَضَّحَ means to clarify. ذَلِكَ, this. فِي كِتَابِهِ, in his book. كما قال المؤلف, as the author said, من وجوه شتى, from many places, بكلام يفهمه أبلد العامة, that the Sheikh مؤلف is Ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab said, من وجوه, from many, Allah clarified it in his book, من وجوه, from different angles, شتى, different, شتى means what? وجوه is different angles. Allah تبارك وتعالى, he clarified Tawheed to us and Ikhlas to us from different angles. بِكَلَامٍ, Allah clarified it with a speech. يَفْهَمُهُ, he will understand it. أَبْلَدُ الْعَامَّةِ, the most general mass a person can be. The most a person can be far from knowledge and the most ignorant he can be, he would what? He would understand that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is saying to him. Let's go back one more time, inshaAllah ta'ala. Let's go back to the Shaykh's speech, rahimahullah, at the beginning. Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah ta'ala, he told us what ikhlasu deenu lillahi ta'ala wahdahu la sharika lah means. He told us what it means and that which we is meant by it. Also, he brought verses to support it. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِ وَنُسُكِ وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And the statement of Allah, وَأَنِيبُوا إِلَىٰ رَبِّكُمْ وَأَسْلِمُوا لَهُ, and also, وَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ الرَّحْمَنُ الرَّحِيمُ فَإِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ فَلَهُ أَسْلِمُوا. And he also said and told us that all the messengers that were sent, what purpose were they sent for, what reason were they sent for? It was to convey that message. إِخْلَاصُ الدِّينِ لِلَّهِ, is to come with sincerity in their worshipping. And how now, the other question is that, how did Allah clarify that? Did he say it in a way where it was so technical, it was so philosophical, that only only a group of people can understand, or even like the Christians who believe in Trinity, who don't even understand the concept of Trinity, that no one understands it. The way Ikhlas was explained is what? In a way that even the person who is a general mass, when he is told, he can understand. Look what Allah said in the Surah Al-An'am. Allah said, وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ فِي الْأَنْعَامِ لَعِبْرَةً نُسْقِيكُمْ مِمَّا فِي بُطُونِهَا مِنْ بَيْنِ فَرْثٍ وَدَبٍ لَبَنًا خَالِسًا. A mother who breastfeeds her child today, for example, what kind of milk would she give her child? Would she take water and add it to her breast milk? أَبَدًا. She would give him pure milk, suckles it from his mother. Allah is saying, if that you're doing that for your own child, and you're only going to give him pure milk, why are you giving me a tainted ibadah? Why don't you give me a ibadah that is purely for my sake? And that is to show you that the Tawheed was explained from many angles. Many angles Allah came from. To show them, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you wouldn't even be pleased for your own child. And then Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also said to the master, you wouldn't even like your slave, your own slave, to work for you and to work for somebody else. You want it to be only for you. Why is it? For Allah who owns you, who's your master, your true master, you would worship him and you will what? You will add somebody else with it for him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from many angles, Allah clarified this. Subhanahu wa ta'ala tawheed. Let's go back to Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen's speech. Let's go back to his speech. فَقَدْ جَاءَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. He came, عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ, our messenger, our prophet, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came with what? He came with بِتَحْقِيقِ التَّوْحِيدِ. It is to solidify. To also what? To bring the reality of Tawheed to the people's eyes. وَإِخْلَاصِهِ وَتَخْلِيصِهِ. And the sincerity, ikhlas, to bring it to the people, وَتَخْلِيصِهِ, and also to get rid of it from every other, مِنْ كُلِّ شَائِبَةٍ, all of the filth and all of the other taints that have fallen into it, puring it from it. That's why he came, the messenger. How did he do it? He did it like this, pay attention. وَسَدِّ كُلِّ طَرِيقٍ وَسَدِّ كل طريق يمكن أن يوصل إلى سلم هذا التوحيد أو إضعافه. He came and he barricaded, he blocked off, عليه الصلاة والسلام, to do what? Every road that would reach you in either getting rid of the توحيد or either reducing the توحيد. حتى until إن رجلا قال للنبي, a man said to the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, ما شاء الله, that whatever Allah wills, وشئت, and you Muhammad will. فقال النبي, the messenger said to him, أجعلتني لله ندا, have you made me equal to Allah? بل rather say, ما شاء الله وحده, say, if Allah alone wills. Are you with me? If Allah alone wills. Don't add me into the Allah's will. Don't add me into it. And if you look at it, that man, his mistake that the Prophet corrected him on, alayhi salatu wasalam, what was it on? Just a letter. Just a wow. Nothing more, nothing less. What did he say? أَجَعَلْتَنِي لِلَّهِ نِدًّا. Have you made me equal to Allah? By saying what? مَا شَاءَ اللَّهُ wa shita. But if he said this, what about this? Ma sha Allahu thumma shita. Would that be wrong? No. Thumma shows after Allah's will, your one comes. Your one is not level to Allah. Then, brothers and sisters, a person can fall into what? He can fall into shirk by just a letter. It doesn't have to be sentences. It doesn't have to be prostrating only. It can be bigger than that. أجعلتني, did you make me, لله ندا, have you made me equal to Allah? بل rather say, ما شاء الله, that which Allah wills, وحده alone, that which Allah تبارك وتعالى wishes alone. This hadith, Imam Ahmad narrated it, Ibn Majah, An-Nasa'i, Bukhari in his Adab al-Mufrad, Abu Nu'aym in his Hilyatul Awliya, wa Tabaqatul Asfiya, At-Tabarani in his Kabir, At-Tahawi fil Mushkili, And this hadith is sahih. Sheikh Al-Albani authenticated it in his silsila hadith is sahih. Also, Sheikh Al-Albani authenticated it in his sahih adab al-mufrad. Good. Ibn Uthaymeen goes on saying, فَأَنْكَرَ النَّبِيُّ The messenger rejected and he showed opposition towards what? عَلَى هَذَا الرَّجُلِ For this man. أَنْ يَقْرِنَ مَشِيئَتَهُ بِمَشِيئَةِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى For him to what? أَنْ يَقْرِنَ It is to mention it together. It's to mention something together. أَنْ يَقْرِنَ For him to mention together. مَشِيئَتَهُ Allah's will. بِمَشِيئَتَهُ The Prophet's will, sorry. بِمَشِيئَةِ اللَّهِ With the will of Allah. To mention that the Prophet rejected it, was against it. Hayyatash Ibn Uthaymeen is going to give you to you. بِحَرْفٍ Just on a letter. Just a letter. يَقْتَضِي That letter, it means and it holds التَّسْوِيَةَ بَيْنَهُمَا That you make Allah and His Messenger equal. وَجَعَلَ ذَلِكَ أَنَّ messenger made ذلك من اتخاذ الند لله عز وجل and the prophet the usage of that letter he considered it and he saw it as making him equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala where will they go the day of judgment the ones who take the prophet's name and they're right next to the prophet's name on their wall they stick the prophet next to it and they're all both on the same line will they not be worse than just a letter will they not be just worse than a letter na'am وَمِنْ ذَٰلِكَ أَيْضًا And also, when we say وَمِنْ ذَٰلِكَ أَيْضًا أَيْضًا what? Where does it, because the word أَيْضًا means also and again. Where does that go back to? It goes back to the Prophet protecting the Tawheed. It goes back to, the أَيْضًا means how Rasulullah protected the Tawheed. Because that's what we were talking about, right? وَمِنْ ذَٰلِكَ أَيْضًا And also from him protecting the Tawheed, حِمَايَةِ جَنَابِ التَّوْحِيدِ was what? أَنَّ النَّبِيَّ That the messenger حَرَّمَ He prohibited الْحِلْفَ أَمَا الْحَلْفَ بِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ He prohibited that a person swears by other than Allah. You can't say بِالْكَعْبَ or I swear by my mom or I swear down or I swear left. You can't do all of that. It is not permissible, or to say, bin Nabi, I swear by the Prophet. I swear, all of that is prohibited. وَجَعَلَ ذَٰلِكَ أَنَّ messenger made that, مِنَ الشِّرْكِ He made it from shirk, associating partners with Allah. فَقَالَ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ The messenger said, مَنْ حَلَفَ بِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ أَوْ أَشْرَكَ Anyone who swears by other than Allah, he's come with disbelief or he has committed shirk. وَذَٰلِكَ And the reason to that is because because of the one who swears بِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ who swears by other than Allah تَعْظِيمٌ لِلْمَخْلُوفِ مَخْلُوقِ Does it say مَخْلُوقِ? Sorry, does it say مَخْلُوقِ?
مَخْلُوف
It's mahlufi, sah. Now, the reason is because بغير الله تعظيم is because the person is honoring للمحلوفي to the thing that he is making the oath to. محلوف is مفعول. It's the one that you're doing the hilf on. You're swearing on him. You're honoring him besides Allah. بما لا يستحقه that the person doesn't deserve it. إلا الله عز وجل. Only Allah is the one who deserves that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah is the only one who deserves that. وَحِينَمَا قَدِمَ عَلَيْهِ وَفْدٌ When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a delegation came to him. فَقَالُوا They said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ O Messenger of Allah, يَا خَيْرِنَا The best amongst us. وَابْنُ خَيْرِنَا And the best of وَابْنُ خَيْرِنَا And the best son of us. وَسَيِّدَنَا And you're our master. وَابْنُ سَيِّدِنَا And you're the son of our master. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to them, يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ O people, قُولُوا بِقَوْلِكُمْ Say the statement you guys were saying. وَلَا يَسْتَهْوِيَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ Don't let shaitan divert you. Don't let shaitan take you guys away from the haqq. Ana Muhammad, I am Muhammad. Abdullah, I am the slave of Allah. Wa rasuluhu, and I am his messenger. Ma uhibbu, I do not love. An tarfa'uni, that you guys lift me. Fawqa manzilati, that you guys lift me above my status. Allati anzalani Allahu azza wa jal, the status which Allah gave me. I don't like it that you guys raise me above the status in which Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gave me. Another narration says what? وَلَا يَجْرِيَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ وَلَا يَجْرِيَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ. And it means لَا يَتَّقِذَنَّكُمُ الشَّيْطَانُ جَرْيًا. Don't let shaitan take you on his path by diverting you from the good and from the tawheed to shirk. Our messenger didn't want anyone to take him above his status. He didn't like it. This hadith is narrated by Imam Ahmad, and it's a hadith which is authentic. Na'am. Another time they came to him and they said, Abdullah ibn Shakhir said, radiallahu ta'ala an, that a delegation from the delegation of Bani Amir, the people of Bani Amir, they came to the messenger and they said to the Prophet, Anta Sayyiduna, you are our master. And the messenger said to them, As Sayyidullah, the master is Allah Azza wa Jalla, Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Who's the master? The master is Allah, the Prophet said. And we know the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, is he not a master? He said it himself. Ana Sayyidu Waladi Adam. I am the master of the children of Adam. He said that. But why did he not allow it here? The reason why he saw alayhi salatu wasalam that the people may go extreme on him. He didn't want that, alayhi salatu wasalam. Why did he? Because his purpose and the reason he came, sallallahu alayhi wasalam, is what? Himaya is to safeguard Janabi Tawheed. It is for him to safeguard the boundaries of the Tawheed. That was his job, alayhi salatu wasalam. And imagine if he saw the call of Busiri in his burda today, that he says, وَإِنَّ مِنْ جُودِكَ الدُّنْيَا وَضَرَّتَهَا وَمِنْ عُلُومِكَ عِلْمَ اللَّوْحِ وَالْقَلَمِ. That from your knowledge, Muhammad, is what? The knowledge of the unseen, you know everything. That was happened, that which is happening, that which is going to happen, that which hasn't happened. If it was to happen, how would it have happened? The Prophet knows that. That's what they're saying. And that is for who? عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ فَلَا يُظْهِرُ عَلَىٰ غَيْبِهِ أَحَدًا. It is the unseen. Who's the one who knows that? عَالِمُ الْغَيْبِ. Allah is the one who knows the unseen. And Allah does not show the unseen to anybody. And He only shows the Prophet whatever He wants to tell him. Like to open all of the unseen to him? Not at all.